Hi, I'm Daniel Teller with the OMEN Displays team. Today, I'm going to walk you through how to set up and use OMEN Gear Switch. OMEN Gear Switch is an advanced KVM. And what that means is you can drive two PCs at the same time using the same set of peripherals while you can seamlessly software switch them back and forth. First, let's hook up our desktop. Now, you can use one of the HDMI ports or the display port, which is what we're using. And now we're gonna hook up the USB-C cable that is data only. These will both be going to our desktop. Another thing to keep in mind is to make sure that you're using the correct cables provided with the display or equivalent cables, and you're using the correct ports on your PC. You wanna make sure that the data transfer rate is going to match what is required for Gear Switch in order for it to function correctly. Now, let's hook up our laptop with the USB-C DP-Alt cable and put that into the DP-Alt port. And then we will hook up our mouse. You can identify the mouse port. It has an icon above it. It's this first USB port. And then for the keyboard, we'll use the number one port, and two and three, you can hook up whichever other peripherals that you are going to use. After all your connections are correct, you want to launch OMEN Gaming Hub, go into the OMEN Transcend 32, and select Gear Switch. Here it'll prompt you to install the Gear Switch software. Go ahead and hit yes, and once that's installed, you'll see this screen appear. You can just skip through all this or close it. And now Gear Switch is ready to be enabled. Make sure to open OMEN Gaming Hub on both devices and click on Gear Switch so it will install the drivers for both systems. Without this, they won't see each other. We'll go ahead and turn it on. And now you should be presented with a screen that looks similar to this. So once Gear Switch is on, you can enable file transfer, which you can drag and drop files across both platforms, as well as copy and pasting files, text, pictures, whatever you're doing, across both platforms. I can move my mouse to the threshold of the monitor, and it'll come down over here on the laptop, so I can control both devices at the same time using the same set of peripherals. And if I come back across, you see the mouse comes back over to here. Now, one thing I can do is if I have other USB devices plugged in, I can software switch them to whichever platform I want and lock them down. So if I needed to take a call over here on my work laptop while I'm gaming, I can, you know, set my device to run on USB-C and lock it in so it'll stay on that platform. Another thing I can do is decide which platform I want to control the audio and lighting and lock that in or switch them on the fly. I can also choose to split this screen with picture in picture, and I've got three options here. I can split it right down the middle, I can split it off to either side and choose which side I want which PC to appear on. So right now I have this laptop running in mirror mode with my other desktop running in full screen on this screen. One thing I can't do is move this PC to the other side. So this will forever be on this side unless I choose to split the screen, then I can choose which side I want my laptop to be on and it'll flow across the screen on that side. So let me go ahead and split that so I can show you real quick. Now that the PCs are split, as you can see, they're on the wrong side, so I can go into my OSD and swap these. Now my desktop is on the right side, and my laptop is on the left side. And you can see I can move the mouse back and forth still between both platforms. Another thing I can choose to do is do picture in picture. So now my laptop is full screen, my desktop shows up in this picture where I can place in the four quadrants or resize as necessary. If I go into the OSD, I can choose to resize some of these. You go to input and go pip size, and I can change how big that appears. But I also want my desktop to be full screen, so again, I can go up here to the top and swap which is my primary and which is my secondary input. And now this is back to my desktop and my laptop is over here. Now all of the settings to control this will either appear in OMEN Gaming Hub or you can go into the on-screen display and make those changes directly. An additional detail that I would like to mention that if you have the OSD open, you cannot also control the monitor from OMEN Gaming Hub. You must close the OSD first, otherwise it'll throw an error at you saying that the display is busy. They'll be in the input settings, and you can see here all of the settings flow across. There's your KVM controls and your gear switch controls. You can choose which ports to bind where. So I can choose my lighting of the platform over here, display over here, and whichever USB ports that I want.
And that's it for OMEN Gear Switch. If you want to learn more about the OMEN Transcend 32, please visit support.hp.com. Thanks for watching.